time for the match game, Hollywood Square. Our whiz from Gimme a Break, Lori Hendler. From Happy Days, Erin Moran. From the movie Police Academy, Michael Winslow. From Laverne and Shirley, Eddie Mecca. From Laverne and Shirley again, David L. Langner. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares are G. Raver and John Bauman.
Wild bunch out there.
Somebody's been drinking coffee.
What are you're switching answers already? We haven't even answered a question yet.
No, we're comparing hands, you know, to see who had the coldest hands.
Really?
And Erin won. So let's hear it for Erin, shall we?
What did she win, David?
I don't know, but I sure like using that voice. She can win this voice. She can win my old voice.
You want my job? Mm-hmm. I'll trade places with you.
Oh, come on, Gene. How could I do that with you?
All right, if you're all ready, we'll all have a brisk round of applause for these two people over here. They are Clayton Wallace and Joanne Wind. Now we're going to find out a little bit about each of you. We'll begin with you, Clayton. And I suppose it gets boring for people to tell you that you look like J.C., huh?
I hear that every once in a while.
Really? Doesn't he? Don't you think he does? You don't know what I'm talking about. Johnny Carson, that's right.
Oh, I thought you meant the other one.
Doesn't he look like Johnny Carson? Take a look at him.
Yeah, he does. Yeah,
sure he does.
Yeah.
Where are you from, Clayton?
Yeah.
J.C.
I'm from Ontario, California. I moved out from Des Moines, Iowa about 10 years ago. I'm an ordained minister. I have a pastorate of a congregation in Upland, California. I was born married. I have three.
That's Johnny Carson.
I have three grown children and a very lovely wife.
Okay, Clayton, nice to have you with us. All right, now let's find out about Ed McMahon here. Tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm a student and I'm studying business administration. I live in Ontario also.
Oh, really?
Yes, almost neighbors. No, and I live on a dairy out there.
You live on a what?
A dairy with cows. And
oh, a dairy farm.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Can you milk a cow?
Can I? Actually, I can't milk a cow. I don't like to go in the barn. And
can you hook up a machine?
Yeah, I can do that.
You do that.
I'm scared of the cows kicking me, though, so I don't. See, and I'm looking forward to October. I'm getting married.
All right. We wish you well, Joanne.
Thank you.
And we wish both of you well here. I hope one of you walks away from here with a bundle of money. We'll begin with the match game. Play three rounds. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Clayton won the toss, so that means he'll go first.
I'll take B, please.
All right, sir. Clayton, you're an ordained minister.
Correct.
Come to the wrong show.
All right.
Father Murphy.
We're all in trouble now.
Say, I just saw a new movie and it's really strange. In this one, Blank gets the girl. Strange new movie.
Can we say anything we want?
Anything you want. Well, now we just... Fine.
Oh, I threw that one out, the one I was going to say.
All right. You ready, Michael? Michael's just doing a little artwork, Clayton, so we'll put the question to you.
Get away.
It's about this new movie, a really strange new movie, and this one, Blank gets the girl.
The villain.
The villain gets the girl. That would be a good traditional answer. Instead of the hero getting the girl, the villain gets the girl. What do you say?
I saw this movie, and it really wasn't the villain. It was the girl that got the girl.
The girl gets the girl.
There we go again.
Not a booable answer. That's a very creative, imaginative answer.
Yes, Eddie, I thought it was a very good answer.
She must have that too. Sitting in these seats here, one would never expect an ordained minister to say the girl gets the girl.
I'm sorry.
They said it anyway.
Depends on what cable program.
Yeah, I.
You said the girl gets the girl. All right, David.
I would do that on cable.
I must be having a communication problem or something because, thank you, because I always thought it would be the blank gets the girl would lead to the girl gets the girl, but since it wasn't, it was blank gets the girl. We always hear in those movies, and at the end, he gets the girl. Well, at the end, she gets the girl would be what
she
I would say.
She gets the girl? It's well, we see the same as the girl
it
gets
works
the girl.
Dramatically. All right.
So we have three of those in the upper tier. Let's see if we have down here, beginning with John.
You know, you're kind of falling down and you're booing a little bit. And it's early in the show, you know. We don't want you to poop out early in the show, so could you just kind of jazz it up a little bit? I said, girl gets the girl. My kind of crap.
That's the way.
Laurie?
Oh, well, I'm sensitive, so I'd like applause for a girl.
Okay. Have five of those so far. Michael.
Missile's ready. Go ahead and boobie if you want to. Girl.
Six of those. Got them all, did you? Okay. I took care of them. Joanne, this is yours. Here it is. Nerdocrumbesia, such a strange country, they play music by slapping two blanks together.
What? I didn't hear the first part.
One more time now.
Say it's nerdo. Nerdocrumbesia. That's a mythical, dumb, crummy country of ours.
Nerdocrumbesia.
A strange country, they play music by slapping two blanks together.
You must get foreign aid from us.
Now, in a round one question, anything that comes into your head, anything, slapping two, whatever you think will make...
I'm falling behind here.
I'm serious, but...
Put it in the slot.
He doesn't know how to spell that either.
Okay, Laurie?
I'm gonna get booed.
Yes. All right, Eddie, here we are, Joanne. Nerdocrumbesia, such a strange country. They play music by slapping two blanks together.
Two eggs.
Two eggs?
That wouldn't...
That's creative.
Oh, that's not musical.
Now, that's great. We can make a show out of it.
That would be very difficult to do and would be quite a challenge, wouldn't it? A
lot of eggs.
I'll pay to see that.
I'd pay to see this, too.
Slapping two musicians together.
Hey! It's a lousy answer, but hey!
They're your people, Eddie.
They do that in studio.
Aaron.
Silly.
What kind of people?
Oh, well, people.
Two people. No way.
David? For this to make any sense, you have to say it all over again, and then this will make sense.
Nerdocrumbesia.
Nerdocrumbesia.
Crumbesia.
It's a weird country.
It's such a strange country, they make music by slapping two...
Nerds together, because it's
nerds. That's good.
Play on words, I imagine.
Very
play
creative.
On nerds, actually.
Excellent. Yeah. Well done. All right, John.
Well, I would just like to slap two of these, but in this case, I suppose we could slap them together. Politicians.
Two politicians. All right.
They don't slap.
Joanne is looking for eggs, an unlikely possibility.
Could I just get a buzz and leave it at that?
All right.
I have to show this.
Two
thighs.
Two thighs.
That's okay.
That's good.
Myself.
Wasn't there a song like that?
Something like that.
Slap of your feet, slap of your thighs. Then there was a make a sound by
Gene. If your knees knock, lean on them. Kneel on them.
If your all knees right. knock together. If your knees knock, kneel on them.
Kneel on them.
Very good
that's
idea.
That's what all the ministers always say.
Yeah.
I said knocking two heads together, like the Three Stooges.
What kind of? Hold on.
Why you? I'm money. You.
I want to hear what kind of sound that would make knocking two heads together. Huh. Oh, you could play a whole song that
That's
way.
That's too coffee
Very good. Yeah. So there's round one, 0-0. Round two coming up right after this. Hurry back.
From classic concentration to Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
Right to agree, and you win the game.
Never have so many shows been so primed for prime time. Buzzer Prime, weeknights starting at 8, right here on Buzzer.
Here we go with round two. Now, since the score is tied 0-0 and he went first last time, Joanne, we'll ask you to go first this time.
A, please.
All right, she wants A, and here's what it says. Harry said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, our apartment didn't have wall-to-wall carpeting. Instead, we had wall-to-wall blank.
It's away, it's history now. Put it away.
That's good, Larry.
Light it up.
Sure. Light a slot.
I need all the encouragement I can get, I think.
All right, Michael, here we go. Joanne. Harry said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, our apartment didn't have wall-to-wall carpeting. Instead, we had wall-to-wall blank.
Wall-to-wall dirt?
Dirt. All right.
Stronger than dirt.
Dirt works here. She says dirt, Eddie.
Stronger than dirt.
Dirt it is. One for Joanne. A surprise.
I think that's a darn good answer.
Dirt it is. Surprise me.
It
dude.
Seems to me I remember this. It's an old joke. We were so poor, we didn't have wall-to-wall carpeting. We had wall-to-wall floors.
Floors.
It's an old joke, but not... but a hard worker. Oh, come on. Now.
An old joke beyond our remembrance there.
I remember that was funny.
Wall-to-wall floors.
Okay.
You remember that?
That's right. It's an old joke, but it just might not work.
Yes. Now, what have you got?
Well, the notion... I thought that carpeting implies something on the floor, so I said... toilet paper, you see, because that would be...
All right, Laurie.
Well, I figure if they're really poor, they have wall-to-wall cockroaches.
Wall-to-wall cockroaches.
I love you guys. Thank you. Oh, I feel so good today.
Now, your answer seemed to amuse Laurie when you were writing it. What did you write?
Well, hey, man, you know, like, we've been poor for a long time, man.
Yeah, you know, we don't have wall-to-wall carpeting, but we got wall-to-wall eviction notices, man.
That's great.
So, Joanne, you pick up two. Now, Clayton, this one's for you. Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
She thought you got thin mints by taking fat mints and blanking them.
What?
She must have been dumb. I'm pretty stupid, too.
Yeah, I got one.
Okay, Aaron. Aaron.
Yes.
Here we go, please.
Yeah.
Dumb Dora was so dumb, she thought you got thin mints by taking fat mints and blanking them.
Breaking them in two.
Breaking them in two. They're not too thrilled with your answer, Clayton.
I don't know. That's
but
not bad.
But you can
bad.
Always get a job as Johnny Carson's stand-in.
Not bad.
Eddie?
That was my second choice. I said shrinking.
Shrinking. All right, shrinking is one possibility.
Silence. I like that.
Aaron?
What? I'm waiting for a boo. Here it comes.
Shrinking. No?
There we go.
They don't think it's too bad, David.
Want to use this?
No.
Yes.
Well, I frankly was very confused by the question.
Really?
So I even put a question mark after my answer. So that's sort of an answer question. Remember the answer man? Never mind. I say it again, so at least it makes some sense why I said it.
Dumb Dora was so dumb she thought you got thin mints by taking fat mints and blanking them.
And losing them. You lose weight, you lose fat.
Lose weight. Uh-huh.
These are very complex answers.
Oh, my goodness. You're beautiful when you're angry.
David, you're too intellectual for this show.
I know, I think so. You remember the show, It Pays to Be Ignorant? If I was on that show, I'd be a millionaire.
That's right. Uh-huh. What have you got for
What's
us,
What's my problem? I thought this was clever, but it doesn't match, by taking fat mints and exercising them.
All right. That's good. Laurie?
What station do you listen to?
What do you say?
By sitting on them.
Sitting on them. That'll make them thin. Michael?
Yeah, that's what I thought. Sitting on
sitting
them.
Sitting on them.
Hey, you want your mints, Lee? Get your mints right here.
All right. So, 2-0, Joanne's ahead, the end of round two. Third and final round coming up right after this for you.
One, eight, two.
Say it again.
One,
eight, two. One,
eight,
two.
Here we go with the third and final round. There they are. Joanne, you're ahead. We'll ask you to go first.
Let's try B.
Let's try B. Four people play. David in the lower tier.
David and the Lower Tier. Remember that rock group? Boy, were they
sounds
good.
Like a great team.
They were so interesting.
David and the Lower Tier. That would be a
David
good group.
David and the Lower
Tier. That's a good group.
Dumb Donald was so dumb.
Wait a minute, who's this dumb one?
Dumb Donald.
Any relation to Dumb Dora?
He tried to impress his date by ordering in French. Unfortunately, they were at a blank. Tried to impress his date.
One more time.
He was dumb. He tried to impress his date by ordering in French. Unfortunately, they were at a blank.
How come everyone isn't playing? Something I said?
Yeah.
Gee, kind of feel bad about that.
Joanne, Dumb Donald was so dumb he tried to impress his date by ordering in French. Unfortunately, they were at a blank.
At a Mexican restaurant?
Mexican restaurant is good.
I don't believe it. He was so dumb he tried to impress his date by ordering in French. Unfortunately, they were at a Burger King.
Burger King. That's good.
I mean, he's already lost.
Burger King. What do you got there, John?
Unfortunately, they were at a pizza parlor. Mangia.
Oh, yes. All right, Joanne's looking for a Mexican restaurant. What do you got?
Well, it's a restaurant, but it's a Chinese restaurant.
Chinese.
Yeah. I mean, can you imagine the guy in a Chinese restaurant?
A Chinese restaurant. Well, you didn't pick up any there. Now, Clayton, you're in a good spot here. You need 2 to tie and 3 to win. Let's see what happens. Louis' restaurant is so bad that in addition to a full-time chef, they also have a full-time blank.
Okay.
It's so stupid that I can't. I love the music, man. If we could write some lyrics, if we can, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
We could do it. All right, Aaron, here we go. Louis' restaurant is so bad, and in addition to a full-time chef, they also have a full-time blank.
Doctor.
Doctor is good.
What?
You did it. Two doctors will tie it. Three will win it.
Well, if he cooks like my wife, I'm just kidding, honey.
Doctor.
No, doctor it is. All right, score is now 2-1. Aaron?
Doctor.
All right, we got a tie score.
I'm afraid the sense of the macabre got the best of me. It was such a bad restaurant. In addition to a full-time chef, they had a full-time mortician.
Uh-huh.
That's bad. I'm not
full-time
happy with
mortician.
That either. So.
At this moment, we have a tie. Let's see if we break the tie down here. John?
Not yet. I agreed with David. I said Undertaker.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Shows where we spend our afternoon.
Yeah, well, that's...
Okay.
Can't get much worse than that.
This may be a match. It's a nurse. It's close.
No.
Nope.
No.
No. That's not bad
Let's
at all.
See if we're going to end up a tie... It's all up to you, Michael. Michael, it's all on your shoulders.
Health inspector, pay me and I won't say
health
nothing.
Health inspector, the game ends in a tie.
Come on.
Now we've got to go to the tiebreaker. Here is the tie-breaking question. I will give it to you. Blank pancakes. Blank pancakes. Now, in front of you here, but out of sight of the stars, are 4 pretty good responses to that. And your seats were determined by lot, so Joanne, you'll go first. I'll ask you to tell me which of the answers you want by number, if you please, don't say any words. 1, 2, 3, or 4?
Number 3.
You want number 3? All right, Clayton, tell me of the remaining ones which you would like to have.
Number 1.
Number 1 is his. All right. I'm going to go over here and get verbal responses from the stars. Soon as you hear your answer, let me know if you please. Eddie, just a verbal response. Blank pancakes. What do you say?
Blueberry?
Blueberry. No blueberry over there. Aaron?
House of
pancakes. Not yet.
Is it pancakes singular or pancakes?
Pancakes plural.
Oh, listen, I have to know this. It's my job.
Yeah. That's right.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Potato pancakes.
Potato pancakes is a terrible answer.
It's a terrible food. No, you'll get letters. You'll get letters.
Well, that depends, Gene. Whether you think that's a terrible answer or not. I happen to think it's pretty good, but I'm going to say buttermilk pancakes.
Jemima. All right. Clayton, it was a pleasure to meet you. I'm going to send some gifts to you from the Match Game. Clayton Wallace, ladies and gentlemen, there you go. Hello there. Well, congratulations to you. How do you feel?
I am so nervous.
Are you really? All right, well, we'll calm you down. Here comes the rest of our set. We're going to go to Hollywood Squares now. Three stars will be up here in a moment or so. John and I will trade places. Lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive the Silver Reed Penman, fully electronic, compact, daisy-wheel typewriter. Practical enough for the home, durable enough for the office, furnished by Silver Reed. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Square. Hour with Nedra Bowles. Linda Goodfriend. From the Facts of Life, Mindy Cohn. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Plowman.
Thank you. We'll be back in a couple of minutes to play Hollywood Squares. Be there. She just kind of blew through the Match Game, or breezed through the Match Game. She's moving right on to Hollywood Squares. We have three brand new celebrities to join us. They are Nedra Bowles, Linda Goodfriend, and Mindy Cohn. Mindy, you have been on Facts of Life since its beginning, and how long ago was that?
That was almost 6 years ago.
And how old were you when you started?
13.
That is unbelievable.
I know.
It's a terrific show. I love
Thank
it. So
you.
You're picked up for next season, as we
yes.
all know, because you're so popular.
Knock on metal.
And, right, and congratulations to you, and
Thank
it's good
you.
To have you here. Joanne, let's you and I zip over here and play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And before we begin, we will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champ. She is Lisa Sparrow. It is her second day. Her total so far, $1,475. Wow. Which was a pretty good day yesterday. You got everybody real excited because you did manage to pull the $30,000 number, but you didn't match. Well, who knows? C'est la vie. There may be another chance today. It's only your second day, so why don't you just run through the synopsis of your life to date in 25 words or less.
Okay, I'm a full-time student at Mount St. Mary's College, and I'm looking forward to graduating soon with my bachelor's degree in business with an emphasis in marketing, and I like dancing, jet skiing, and winning.
Okay, well, you're doing very well on the winning side so far. Let's see if you will continue today. Joanne Wynn will have something to say about that during the Hollywood Squares game, which we're going to play until you hear the Time's Up bell. I'll hear it too. Whoever's ahead at that point goes on to play Supermatch and can win up to $30,000. First game's always worth $100, $25 for every square. Lisa Sparrow, take a good look at that board and pick a star.
Mindy, please.
Okay, Mindy Cohn.
Good luck, Mindy. Oh, thanks, Aaron. I'm ready.
Mindy, you're crying your eyes out.
Typical, yeah.
Is it probably the daytime or the nighttime?
I speak personally in the morning. My eyes are out to here and my nose is running. I would have to go with the daytime.
She says if she's crying her eyes out, it's probably the daytime. Uh-huh. What do you say, Lisa?
I agree.
It is probably the nighttime. And you should have disagreed with so Mindy. And your opponent gets the first square. You were clear on that, right? The daytime is when they have the reruns of your show, and the nighttime is when the first run shows run. Joanne wins your move. You have 1-0 up there already, and you're playing 0. Pick a star.
Aaron.
Yes. Aaron Moran.
Go, Aaron. Come on.
Okay.
Aaron, you're getting married.
Oh, really?
But
when?
Is he here today?
No, he's at home.
Okay. You're getting married, but the night before your wedding, the groom dies.
Oh, no.
No wonder he's at home.
Keep going.
Now, according to Emily Post, is it all right to keep his engagement ring?
Yeah.
That's cold.
No.
That's cold, man.
These are things we gotta know.
That is cold.
Is it all right to keep his engagement ring, or should you return it to his family?
Oh. I would keep it.
Okay. She says it's all right to keep his engagement ring. Agree or disagree, Joanne?
I must agree.
It is all right to keep his engagement ring. Yes, you're right to agree. And you get another square. Exactly. Well done. Please return the body, however. Lisa, it is your move for another, for an X. She's got a bunch of O's up there. Pick a star.
Jean to block, please.
Now, this is pivotal because you missed this one. It's the first game for Joanne. Jean Rayburn, is it okay to pick up an adult dog by the scruff of the neck? Or should you save that for your rotten teenagers?
No, that hurts a dog. You shouldn't do that. It's not good. Not by the ears or the scruff or the neck or any of that stuff. Because he weighs too much and it's going to hurt him.
He says, don't pick up that dog by the scruff of the neck. What do you say, Lisa? To block.
I agree.
Don't do it to your dog. Yes, good right. for you. You're right to agree. You get the square. And you do block. All right. So you are thwarted in that position, Joanne, but it is your move.
David, Michael, please.
Just almost a split second.
They look so much alike that it's kind of confusing, you know. I understand how something like that can happen.
Should have worn my sunglasses.
Yes, I know.
Michael Winslow, your cat's hungry, and the only thing you have left in the refrigerator
is brick.
No.
Is what?
No. Is a dead mouse. Would your cat prefer it cold? Or should you heat it in the microwave?
How would Emily Post eat this mouse? To ask her.
You hungry? Okay. There's only a mouse in here. You want it anyway? Okay. Do you want it in the microwave or do you want it as is? As is. Because it would explode in a microwave. Robin Williams proved that.
I mentioned yesterday, last time Michael was on the show, he did bring us the cat in the blender, and this time he is followed with an encore, the mouse in the microwave. Thank you very much. But he says your cat would prefer it cold. So what do you say, Joanne?
I disagree.
You should heat it in the microwave. Good for you. You're right to disagree. You get the square, and you win the game. I mean, you don't win the game. My mistake. You just got a bunch of O's up there, and we're going to find out who does, in fact, win the game right after these messages. See you then.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
This summer, Buzzer turns the wee hours into...
The Wee Hours!
Anarchy!
Buzzer's Nightcap. Tonight, starting at 2. All night on Buzzer.
Now back to John Bauman at the Hollywood Square.
Thank you. Well, I almost gave Joanne the game prematurely. She hasn't got it yet, but boy, she did take a big advantage with that last question. Lisa, what are you going to do?
Nidra to block, please.
Uh-huh. Oh,
boy.
You missed this one. The game does belong to Joanne. Nidra Volz, according to Dr. Joyce Brothers, who has more sexual fantasies? A young, inexperienced woman or an older, more experienced woman?
Like Emily Post.
That's the answer. Well, I just happen to know that answer, John. It's an older, experienced woman, so help me, Hannah.
Nidra says, so help me, Hannah, and Dr. Joyce Brothers, an older, more experienced woman has more sexual fantasies. What do you say, Lisa?
I agree.
The older woman has more sexual fantasies. You are right to agree. You get the square, and you do block. Joanne, your move for an O.
Oh, dear. I'll have Eddie to block.
Okay.
He's good at that. You love
Interesting, him. Because you could have taken David to win. She didn't stop you there.
You can still have him.
No, she can't.
He's small. Right.
She said Eddie to block, and Eddie make it to block. It is.
Okay.
What did Americans spend more money on last year, Eddie? Frozen pizza or antacid?
Pizza.
That's right.
Hey, when you know, there's no thinking about it.
Okay, that's it. He says people spend more money on frozen pizza. What do you say, Joanne?
I'm not tying for that.
To block.
I'll disagree.
Americans spent more money last year on frozen pizza. You should have agreed with Eddie. Your opponent gets that square, and your opponent really does win the game. Manja, 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 over $1 billion. dollars worth of frozen pizza, 1 billion consumed in America last year.
That's what I figured.
So,
1 billion.
That might have been a strategic error, and it certainly didn't work out very well. Joanne, you gave the first game to Lisa, but we're going to move on to a $200 game. Sweep the X's and O's off of the board, and Joanne, you do get to start us off.
Okay, Aaron.
Aaron Moran, once again. Is the sun closest to Hollywood in the dead of winter or in the middle of summer?
I'm there so much, I should know.
Sun? Or Hollywood, I'm sorry. Go ahead, dear. The floor is yours.
In the winter.
In the winter. Agree or disagree, Joanne? She says the sun's closest to Hollywood in the dead of winter.
I agree.
It is closest to Hollywood in the dead of winter. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square, good for you. Right, it's the angle of the sun's rays that makes it warmer or colder, not the distance. Okay, we're going to be back to complete our $200 game right after these messages. Stay with us.
1, 8, 2.
Say it again.
1, 8, 2.
1, 8, 2.
Game going here because it's 175 to 100. Clearly, the $200 game that we are in is pivotal. Lisa Sparrow, you're playing X. Make your move.
Linda, please.
All right, okay. Linda Goodfriend from Happy Days. What's better for diaper rash?
Oh, lemonade? I know this.
Go ahead. I know. That's right. You have a new baby. Lemonade or milk?
I don't know if I know this. Lemonade or milk? To put it on or for them to drink it?
I asked the same question when I saw this. No, it does matter. It's to put it on them.
Lemonade.
Okay, it is to put it on them. It's to rub it on them. Agree or disagree, Lisa?
I agree.
Milk is better for diaper rash, so you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square.
Don't tell my child that I...
Which, as I recall, is just how we started off the $100 game, was with two O's up there for you, Joanne. Try to place a third.
Lori to win.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
Now, if you get this one, it will give you the game and the lead. According to the Los Angeles Police Department,
yeah.
Is the toilet a good place to hide your valuables, or is that one of the first places a burglar goes?
You mean the actual toilet or the room?
Toilet.
Can I get a slight judgment on this? Yes.
In the toilet, you lose them?
The actual toilet was what we researched.
Well, the houses that I've been robbing, oops. No, I wouldn't look in the toilet first. I might look there eventually, but I wouldn't look there first.
So you would say the toilet is, in fact, a good place to hide your valuables.
Sure, what the heck?
What do you say, Joanne, for the game and the lead?
I agree.
It is a good place to hide your valuables. You're right to agree, you get the square, you win the game, and you do take the lead. The reason that I had to look into that a little further, it's the toilet itself, but it's tape your valuables under the tank lid. That's the best place. And hope the tape holds. Congratulations to you, Joanne Wind, but there is still time. Sweep the O's off of the board, and we will start a $300 game with Lisa.
Michael, please.
All right. Let's keep it quick here because time is fleeting. Michael Winslow, you're all alone on Saturday night, so you decide to clean your washing machine.
Yeah.
According to Mary Ellen, you should put this in it and run it through a cycle. Should you put in vinegar or a Brillo pad?
That's easy.
Yeah, what's the answer then, Chuck?
I can't tell you that. It would ruin the whole credentials of the game. I've done it.
Right. He's done it.
Everybody has.
I would think that a Brillo pad, depending on what kind of grime you would have on the side of the washing machine, because you washed everything, including it.
Okay.
In there.
Yeah, I think so he says put a Brillo pad in it to clean the washing machine. What do you say, Lisa?
I disagree.
Vinegar is the best thing. Good. Yes, you're right to disagree. And you get the first square in this game.
You've done that, man.
Joanne, you're playing
vinegar ice cubes yesterday.
Aaron, please.
Aaron Moran. You're in Calcutta, India, and you've just gotten a Big Mac attack.
Lucky you.
Can you get a Big Mac there, or is there no McDonald's in Calcutta?
No.
No McDonald's in Calcutta, she says. What do you say, Joanne?
I disagree.
There is no McDonald's in Calcutta. You should have agreed with Aaron, and your opponent gets that square. No, you cannot get the sacred quarter pounder. So, Lisa Sparrow, that means that you got a mess of X's. Pick a star.
Nidra to win?
Nidra Vols will give you this game and the lead back. Nidra, measured in time, what is longer? The Wright brothers' flight at Kitty Hawk
Or an average hot flash.
He picked this for you.
That's nasty of you to do that, John. Actually, I never had hot flashes. That's the one on you. Ha ha. But I also don't know the Wright brothers personally. But,
which is longer?
I think probably the Wright brothers' flight might have lasted a smidgen longer.
She says the Wright brothers' flight was longer. What do you say, Lisa, for the game?
I agree.
The average hot flash was longer. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square and blocks you instead. The Wright brothers' historic first flight lasted only 12 seconds.
Yeah, that's
how long is the hot flash?
Joanne, you were saved by an O in that square. Pick a star.
Mindy.
Okay, that may have been the pivotal question. Let's see what happens here. Mindy Cohn. Yes. Fluff is the name of her pet cat. Does Fluff belong to Lady Di or Barbie the Barbie doll?
Barbie the Barbie doll.
What do you say, Joanne?
I'll agree.
Fluff is the Barbie doll's cat, so you're right to agree and you get the square. Tables have turned. Lisa, your move for an X.
Linda, to block, please.
Okay, you missed this one. It's really a pretty big lead for Joanne at this point in the day. Linda Goodfriend, your acupuncturist just stuck you all over with pins and then presented you with a bill for $500. Huh. Now, is the $500 tax deductible, or doesn't the IRS allow a deduction for acupuncture?
I look like an accountant today, obviously. I would say it's, sure, tax deductible.
She says acupuncture is tax deductible. What do you say, Lisa, for a very critical block?
I agree.
The $500 is tax deductible. So
well, what do you know? AMA got smart.
And you do block. AMA Joanne wins. Y'all, oh, that means that time is up. She has done it. Joanne Wynn is our new champ. Congratulations to you. Wow. You survived a real strategic error in the first game, and you made it anyway. Now what you do is you zip right over there to Gene Rayburn, get set for your shot at the big money. Well, I don't know what to say other than you did have your chances.
You did have my chances.
Yeah, you did have your chances. There might have been another one coming up had we not run a little bit short on time, but you had a pretty good day here yesterday, and you have a pretty nice total leaving here. $1,725 for Lisa Sparrow. Good for you. Okay.
Here we have the champ. We'll be back with her and the nine stars for going the big goal right after this.
One, eight, two.
Say it again.
One, eight, two. One,
eight, two.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn. Okay, Gino, here we go. You ready, Joanne?
I'm ready.
All right, she could win up to $30,000 here in this super match. Let's wish her well and begin. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Blank mouse. If you give us the answer they mention most often, it's $1,000, then $500, and $250. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer some suggestions here.
Michael.
Well, of course, we've got to go with Mickey Mouse.
Mickey
because
Mouse is his.
Either that or Mike, you know.
Lori?
You know?
Oh, did you call me? I'm sorry. I wasn't listening. Laboratory Mouse.
Laboratory Mouse.
I don't know.
Hey, come on, Mickey.
My cousin.
I don't know. That's my cousin.
Both laboratory you and David rat are too intellectual
we're
for
related
this show.
Well, I'm sorry.
Eddie.
Minnie Mouse.
Yeah. Minnie Mouse.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty good.
So you have Minnie Mouse, Mickey Mouse,
or
and
Destroyer
Laboratory Mouse.
Yeah, Laboratory Mouse.
You want one of those or one of your own?
I'll have Mickey Mouse.
You'll have Mickey Mouse?
Good choice.
I don't blame
yeah
you. He's pretty
pretty
cute.
Good choice. So real good choice, dear.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Who asked you, Donald?
Let's see if Mickey Mouse is up there. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal a $250 response. Yeah. Mighty Mouse. Mighty.
Shut up, Donald.
All
shut
right
up, Donald.
The $500 response says, Minnie Mouse.
Sorry.
Shut up, Donald.
Laboratory Mouse is going to be up there.
No, no.
He's
going to
be up there?
He's
I bet you $1,000 it's not.
He's not a union mouse. Forget it.
You know.
That bet.
No, I don't know.
If he's
don't
union
know
mouse.
No, I have no idea what's
is he
up
sag
there.
Sag
what do you think, audience?
Of course it's
That's
all right, slide it. Yeah! $1,000. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of her choosing. And after you have chosen a star, the star will reveal the hidden number and will multiply that $1,000 by whatever number is revealed at that time. So, time to pick a star.
Aaron.
Ooh.
Aaron, ready?
Yeah.
Want to grab the tab?
Yes.
$20,000 what you're playing for. Good for you. All right, on your mark, face me, and good luck. Here it is. No help from the audience, please. Blank ribbon, R-I-B-B-O-N. Blank ribbon. Aaron has written her answer, Joanne. You think it's a hard one, huh?
I do.
You think it's a hard one?
My mind is blank, but I am going to say yellow ribbon.
That. From the song of the same name, Yellow Ribbon. All right, you'll collect the $20,000 if you match Aaron. Now, may we see your card, please?
I'm sorry.
Red ribbon. Blue ribbon, red ribbon, and yellow ribbon were the three really good responses there, and they each had different ones. So far, you have $1,400, and you're still a champ, and you'll be having a shot at it again tomorrow, but we'll be back with her and the stars right after this. Now we want to find out which of the stars had the big number. Would you all grab your tab, please, and give it a yank? Ready, set, go.
Yank your tab.
Eddie Becker. Becker had the big number was there. Now we're going to grant one wish to Joanne before we leave. What sound would you like to hear Michael make? Name any sound, he'll do it.
Do Donald Duck.
Do Donald Duck.
Time to have your match, everybody. We'll see you next time on the Match Team. Yeah.
And Michael.
Can you do the sound of a yellow ribbon for $20,000? Thanks, everybody.
See you tomorrow, and you'll be back here tomorrow. Joanne, Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
Yeah. And John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Square, Sarah. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Arklow's Gas Grill with a large tempered viewing window. Plus, an informative cookbook, The Pleasures of Gas Grilling, furnished by Arkla Industries. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.